My name is Vasumati.
Yeah, it's pretty singular, Cochrane. The organization, the product that we make, I mean, we are really unique. And it's very difficult to find it because I've looked for other, you know, examples of websites when we're redesigning the website. You know, what are other organizations like Cochrane? You know, 28,000 something people contributing to this effort. Oddly, I always find we have more in common with Wikipedia than we do. We're like Wikipedia with extremely, extremely intense methods.
The Cochrane Library has always been a digital product, and I guess you would say what has been amazing was Ian Chalmers' foresight into seeing where publishing was going. So it's never been a paper product.
The web is our platform. We don't reach anyone any other way. This is it. We have 112 entity sites in the content management system that we have, and they are literally worldwide. Some of them are in as many as four or five languages. Things like Twitter are not a side project, they're actually how we get a lot of dissemination out there, how we connect with partners, how do we spread our information.
The way that we use Twitter has changed so dramatically since we started 2.5 years ago in terms of what we're putting out on the feed in terms of content. And, you know, we've got so much to draw upon as an organization. We're very fortunate.
As soon as you're willing to put information out there through social media, through blogs, through emails, consumers want to be involved. They're out there and they want to be contacted. They want to participate in reviews.
Indeed, nowadays what we tend to do is not just publish that article, we invite authors to record a podcast, we invite authors to participate in a journal club, we ask authors to participate in our CMA tools and materials.
The Cochrane Collaboration has developed software and systems to create reviews and track the vast amount of data needed to produce reliable evidence.
One of the key things for all Cochrane reviews is that they have a standard structure. They're all the same headings within them. They all analyze the data in a consistent way. They present their findings in a consistent way. The way to enforce that is to make people use the same tool. So RevMan is a tool for writing reviews, and it gives you all of the headings under which you write these text. Things like its interactive nature. We know what many people will want to do next after doing step one. So the system can say, which of the following three things do you want to do next? So it's learnt things from it, and it does exactly what it needs to do, which is why it's perfect software for Cochrane reviews.
What I do is mostly about the communication around the software. We have a team of talented developers who write the code for this special software for the collaboration. And then what I do is I work on the website, telling people how to use the software, the help files in the software and other stuff, and also work with a team we have of people who support the users when they need to ask a question.
In order to sustain the groups, we had to build some sort of information management system in order to help us manage with the increase in the workload and to allow contributors around the world to communicate more easily with us. And we've been working on that in the last 10 years, and we've now rolled out the full system, and that's been quite satisfying actually, because it means that people all over the world can access their reviews and get in touch with us in a much more using the information technology in a much easier fashion.
One of the big exciting changes that I think we're going to see in the next 20 years is a different way that people access information, with some of the changes coming with semantic web and all the new internet technologies. And I think the collaboration's in a good position to participate in this just because of the way our reviews are structured.
And the idea of Web 3.0 is to link the data in web pages so that you can say, oh, you're referring to that concept, I'm referring to the same concept over here. That's the same thing. And when you start making those references, you can start linking content together at the level of the data, and it becomes really, really powerful. And for Cochrane, what that means is, you know, we have lots of information in our reviews, and they're sort of locked in this container we call the review. What is the data in there and how does it relate to other parts of the review? How could you extract it out and package it together for a certain context, for a clinician at point of care or for, you know, a consumer?
They're very keen to use the latest technology to move their ideas forward. And particularly with the developments within the Cochrane Register of Studies, all the way through the development process, people have been very keen to use the very latest technology to make sure that everybody gets access to the data that, that the people within the collaboration are producing. All the way through, we've been pushing the limit of what we can do and what we're being asked to do. I think that's always an exciting place to be.